I'm Kristen King, and welcome to IP Go, the show where we take a look at the IPO world, past, present, and future. Last week in the IPO world was quite surreal. So before we check out this week's schedule, let's take a minute to reflect on two mega listings. DoorDash completed an enormous IPO, raising $3.4 billion and ending the week with a market cap of about $55 billion, well over three times greater than its last private valuation. Shares opened at $102 and closed up 86% around the $175 per share mark. The listing was all the more remarkable considering that the firm lost $667 million in 2019 and lost another $149 million in the first 9 months of 2020. Not everyone is a fan of the stock, with commentators pointing to the lack of profitability and huge competition in a race to zero margin business as factors overlooked by the hysteria. Others took their criticism a step further and noted that the firm filed for an IPO as soon as a COVID vaccine was announced. Airbnb, however, was the main show after a really difficult year for the firm. At the start of the pandemic, Airbnb raised $2 billion in debt and equity at an $18 billion valuation. That raise represented a 50% valuation haircut, followed soon after by the laying off of 1,900 workers, roughly a quarter of its workforce. Despite this, the firm raised $3.5 billion last week in a listing that valued the firm at over $100 billion. Airbnb had priced its initial public offering at $68 a share on Wednesday night after already raising the expected price of its shares twice before. The company closed on Friday at $139 a share, an increase of just over 100% on the initial price. This week is a bit more subdued, with seven IPOs scheduled this week looking to raise $1.7 billion in total. The only substantial listing comes on Wednesday when Wish, a San Francisco-based e-commerce software development firm, aims to raise just over $1 billion by issuing 46 million shares within a price range of $22 to $24 per share. To finish up, let's take a look at the Renaissance Capital IPO ETF, which is up 107% year-to-date and 203% since its March COVID lows. Interestingly, on the day that Airbnb listed, the fund sold off 3% from its all-time high. That's all we have time for this week, but as usual, make sure you do your due diligence before making any investment decisions. To find out more about our TrackStar IQ data, sign up to our free newsletter at investingchannel.com/TrackStar. Stay safe and see you next week.